tonight's wild moment. If you're planning a late summer picnic, don't be surprised if some of your guests have six legs, and we're not talking skeeters. NBC's Jack Hubley explains why yellow jackets want your food.
If there's trouble out there, you can usually count on a dog's nose to find it. This time it was just a little bitty hole in the ground, full of yellow jackets. If it buzzes, Trusty is out of there. Yellow jackets are social wasps. Most are yellow and black.
Nests like this one all begin with a single queen that mated last summer and spent the winter in hibernation.
The bald-faced hornet is actually a black and white yellow jacket that builds those big paper nests in trees. But many species build nests underground. Often the only clues to their presence are a small hole and a handful of buzzing bodies at the entrance. But beneath the surface is a multi-tiered nest with thousands of residents. These workers are still enlarging their cave, each is carrying a chunk of soil in its mandibles. Yellow jackets are predators, feeding on a wide variety of insects and their larvae. But by late summer, they're more interested in carbohydrates, which might explain why they seem to be more of a problem at picnics this time of year. Male yellow jackets don't sting, which, come to think of it, is no consolation at all. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
Well, most residents of a yellow jacket colony die with the coming of cold weather. The only wasps to survive are fertile females that have mated. They hibernate in sheltered areas and become next year's queens that will produce new colonies. I think